Hi and welcome to this new tutorial about Abaqus CAE. Today it will be a short video and we will discuss about Hexamesh, so how to mesh this part, for example, into Hexa elements. So this part is a little bit complex. When we go in the mesh module of Abaqus CAE, we can see that the color of this part is orange. So you have to know that this is a color code used by Abaqus CAE to indicate that your part is not meshable in Hexa elements at the current moment. When you go into the mesh controls, you can see that by default, the method chosen by Abaqus CAE is Hexa mesh. And with this color code orange, this method cannot be used for now. For instance, if I try to mesh directly, you have an error message. So in fact, you have two choices at that point. You can change the method to tetra elements, and so the color will change and you can mesh the part in Hexa elements. Let's delete this mesh. Or you can stay with the default method, which is Hexa mesh. And to be able to Hexa mesh this model, you will need to partition it, which means to divide this part into several simpler parts. So use this tool, create partition, and you have the partition for edges, for faces, and for cells. Cells are 3D solid parts. So here it's a solid part, I will use partition for cell. And first of all, I will divide this small lug from the rest of the part, and I will use extend face, for instance. So I will extend this face and it will cut, divide directly down. One part has been divided into two cells, in fact. I have still one part, but I have two cells. So you can see that the color code has changed and Abaqus is already able to mesh the lug in yellow in Hexa elements. Let's try. If I mesh this region, we have Hexa elements. It's not perfect, but it is already possible, you can see. Okay. So now we have to continue on our part to be able to mesh it in Hexa elements. So we can maybe still use extend faces. I will choose this cell to divide, choose this face to extend, create partition, yellow. I will choose this cell and this face to extend. Okay, it's green. So green is a little bit better than yellow because it is the Hexa mesh is possible, and moreover in a structured way. So the same number of elements face to face. Okay, what we can do now maybe is to extrude sweep edge on this part. I will choose this edge and extrude along direction, which will be that one. Okay. Create partition. And so the partition has almost been finished. I've still one cell to partition to be able to examine the model. So I think we can use a plane that will imply this edge and continue here and to cut properly the orange part here to make a good connection on this edge. That is the last problem to solve, so we can define the cutting plane, for instance. I select this partition. And how do you want to specify the plane? So maybe a point on this edge and a normal to the plane, which will be that one. Point and normal. I will select a point on the edge of interest. And the edge normal to my plane. And so I will create a partition normal to this edge. And okay, done. And so everything has a good color code, which is yellow or green. We can stop here. We can maybe change the size to something like to, I don't know, one. Maybe it's a little bit thin, but I will take it, I will try. So I want to mesh all my part, and you can see the result is quite correct. Everything has been meshed in hexa elements because we used the partition system of Abaqus CIE. With the great thing, which is the color code to indicate you when you can or you cannot mesh your model in hexa elements. Final point maybe is to finish the element type assignment. So you can select all the cells or one by one. I will take all that ones. I can see the kind of element used in the model. If, for instance, I do not want to use the reduced integration, I can unselect here. And if, for instance, I want to choose incompatible modes, I can select here. And you can see the Abaqus element type changed by itself. Okay. So that's all for today. Thank you to have followed this video. And see you next time. Bye.